In these and almost all of the wearable devices on the market today that are doing biometric sensing of some kind, and I'll try to stay out of the way here, most of these, in fact, I saw a number the other day that now over 70% of the wearable devices that are coming to market now have PPG sensors in them as the dominant biometric sensor platform. And that's primarily because, well, two reasons. One is the sensor modules can be small enough to get embedded into a wide variety of different devices and different form factors and different use cases. And those use cases are primarily driven by the fact that you can get a broad range of biometrics out of a PPG waveform. So this is a cartoonized version of a PPG waveform. It looks similar to an EKG, and you can obviously get heart rate out of these sensors. And does well. Let me just take a step back and do a quick summary of how this technology works. So, those green blinking lights or other colored blinking lights are shining light into the body, measuring how much of that light is reflected back based on blood flow. So you can see the different changes in the absorption patterns between when the heart beats, absorbs more light, the capillary bed expands, and when it's not beating, that capillary bed contracts, it absorbs less light. This is a very high level version of how this is working, but effectively that's what you're looking at, is the different absorption patterns in that light reflected back off of the capillary bed. So from that, and just to give you a sense of what the amount of light that is actually reflected off of blood flow on average is less than 1%. So it's literally trying to find a needle in a haystack every second or so, however often you're measuring those metrics. The rest of the light gets scattered either in the tissue or gets corrupted by environmental light or motion noise or a variety of different other challenges that are introduced into when you put this sensor technology into a wearable device that by nature is moving around on the human body. So back to the PPG waveform. Heart rate is kind of table stakes these days for wearable devices. But you can also get what I mentioned earlier, the heart rate variability. That's the RR interval is the interval between the peaks of the waveforms here. That's the time between beats of the heart. That is an input to heart rate variability calculations and also cardiac function like the AFib and arrhythmia detection I talked about earlier. When you look at more of the long-form waves, that is an indication around respiration rate and the breathing patterns. You can also see differences in perfusion or how the blood is perfused through the body in whatever location the sensor happens to be located. And then also you can see the amplitude of the waveform has direct attribution around the pulse pressure, which, getting back to your question around blood pressure, this is a key input into estimating blood pressure with these PPG modules.